Krista's professional career and background. He is a licensed broker since 1989 and a financial management consultant to small and medium enterprises. He is also a licensed life insurance professional and also director of Gateway Global Investment Services, vice president and CFO of Nelle Foods Incorporated, Walnut Creek, California, 1987-1988, and various positions as regional branch manager and controller, assistant vice president for corporate finance of Philippine National Construction Corporation. Major trainings is a financial management seminar in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Loan syndication and documentation course in Hong Kong. Importing foods to the United States by the U.S. FDA, San Francisco, California, USA. Also attended seminar on real estate practice in the United States of Bainar, USA, Northern California, San Francisco. Corporate valuation course in Asian Institute of Management in Manila, and numerous specialized and CPE seminars, symposia, conferences, convention, and CPE seminars conducted by PARE, PMRB, and other local member boards. He is an affiliate of Pasay Makati Realty Board since 1988. And occupied various positions and committee chairmanship at PMRB. A past president of PMRB in 1998 and a presidential board advisor and board consultant of PMRB up to present. He is also a lifetime member of PMRB. For this CPE seminar, he will be discussing on Broker's Guide to Sourcing Listings, Property Inspection, and Security and Security Authority to Sell. Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome our speaker, PMRB Past President Bill Coquilla.
Today's lecture, we will have the nitty-gritties of brokerage. Actually, I'm given only 2 hours, so I can only discuss the first module of my lecture. Actually, a lecture ko is whole day, because the whole day concerns the whole lecture for brokerage, the ins and outs of brokerage practice. Kasi yung sa akin eh, from birth to death, sabi nga nila, or from birth to death, from beginning to end, but now I'm only going to give you one module, which is Broker's Guide to Sourcing Listings, Property Inspection, Securing Authority to Sell. So this is very good for you. How many of you are in the business for 3 years at least, or 5 years? So this one is an idea for you, because you cannot learn this in... I learned all of this. What I'm going to impart to you is what I learned in 20 years. Kasi ito, you know, brokering is very unique. Each transaction is unique. You do one transaction, it could be different from the next transaction. Kaya you have to do a lot of transactions to know all of these things. Especially if you want want to do the whole brokerage process. That's why in our board sa Makati, we always tell them, you have to do the brokerage practice yourself. Do not ask anyone or you, yung mga tao nyo to do it for you. Para hindi kayo maloko. Because brokerage is dealing with people, dealing with government, dealing with people who are really there, up there. People who have the money, people who are wealthy, who are their experience, who are successful in their careers. So huwag nyo silang pobulahin, kako. Because these are people that you don't just, titingala ka sa talangit and tell them kung magsisinungaling ka or anything like that. Hindi mo pwede yun sa atin. You have to give them your trust, no? Okay. So, broker's guide to sourcing listings. And who are the veterans here, by the way? 5 years and up. Okay. So, this one is going to be a refresher for you. Alright? Now, let's go for definitions, no? I think, I hope you still know your theoretical definitions of listings, no? Listing refers to the authority given by the seller, buyer, lessor, lessee, owner, borrower, or lender for the broker to negotiate the sale, purchase, lease, mortgage, exchange of real estate property for a stipulated period of time, price and terms, as well as the rate of professional pure commission. Leasing also refers to the stock in trade of the property which the broker is authorized to sell. Loosely used, natin, ang alam mo natin, leasing is just inventory, di ba? It's the thing that we sell. But actually, legally, it is the authority given to you. So, loosely used, do you have a listing in Forbes Park? So, do you have a listing of house to lot? Pero actually, what they are trying to ask you is, do you have the authority to sell a house in Forbes Park? Ganun po yun. It's like condominium. Do you know that condominium is not just the four corners unit? It's not. Condominium is a form of ownership. You should remember that. Loosely used again, we think that condominium is the unit. No. Actually, the condominium is the air that we occupy. Condominium means it's a form of ownership. So just like here in listing, it is the authority. Eh, dapat malaman nyo yan. Yan po ang theoretical view natin, no? Legal meaning niya. So, it is the stock in trade. Inventory. Kalinaw po yan, ha? Hey! Ang picture ko lumalabas. Okay, what are the kinds of listings? As to form, we have verbal. This verbal listing, alam nyo naman yan, verbal. No? I don't need to expound that. Written, something formal, something written. Now, verbal. Although this is an authority na valid ito, no? They recognize this. Don't do this. You should always have a written authority. Kasi alam nyo, you can only do yung verbal. Sa mga people you know very well, people close to you, your family probably, your cousin, your brother, your sister, no? But don't do it to other people. Kasi marami yung, alam nyo naman, if you're in the practice, mahirap po ito. Bakit di mo kayo mabayaran ng komisyon? Ito pong lecture po ngayon is practical po ito, ha. Wala po tayong theoretical dito, wala tayong books dito. You can only get this from the book of experience. Kaya ako, ituturo ko sa inyo is what I have experienced for the past 20 years. Now, if you want to follow it, fine. No? If you want to emulate it, that's fine. But I know you have your own style of doing things. No? But what I'm going to say here and tell you is what I practice. So, okay, next. exclusivity. Not exclusive or open. Listing wherein two or more brokers are authorized to negotiate the sale of the property. And we have exclusive, a listing where only one broker is authorized to negotiate the sale. And there are two kinds, exclusive agency and the exclusive right to sell. Not exclusive or open. Alam na mo natin lahat yan. This is open. Alam to brokers, one listing, hawak ng maraming brokers. It's open. No? Yan ang style ng mga owners and sellers. They always give it all to brokers. But later on, we'll talk about yung mga authority na yan. No? In an exclusive listing, you can get an exclusive listing from an owner. But, akala nyo, porque exclusive na kayo, exclusive na sa inyo lahat yun. No. Because once the owner gets the buyer himself, sorry na lang, wala kayong commission. That's how it's defined. No? That's why if you want to take everything and you can sleep in peace, get an exclusive right to sell. Yung exclusive right to sell, maski natutulog kayo, may 50% na kayo. Kasi whoever sells it, you're entitled to a commission. Babayaran at babayaran ka naman. But when it is an exclusive agency lang, pag nabenta po yan ng owner, sorry na kayo. Pero alam nyo, karamihan mo ng mga sellers, hindi naman nila alam kung yung exclusive right to sell and exclusive agency, di ba? So when, don't tell them. Huwag nyo sasabihin na, ganito po exclusive right to sell, ganito po exclusive. Hindi ho nila alam yun eh, unless they really understand. Well, probably they are lawyers. Pero, pagkausap nyo yung seller, pag humingi kayo ng exclusive listing, sabihin nyo lang exclusive. Mami, explain ko sa inyo, pag-usap na kayo sa seller, why they have to give you an exclusive listing. Pero ang exclusive right to sell, bihira kung binibigay yan. No? In my 20, almost 25 years of practice, I only got 8 exclusive right to sell. Pahirapan pa ho yan. Because my exclusive right to sell contract, yung authority ko, is 8 pages. 8 pages po yan. Ano kayo, ano? But I don't give it out because may marami ho akong mga ano dyan, mga trade secrets. No? But you have to explain each and every provision in your authority to sell to the owner. That's why when I give an exclusive right to sell, I sit down with the owners and explain to them each and every thing that is stated there. Kasi hindi lang po, kasi they have to understand it eh, why you are asking for an exclusive right to sell. So yan po, yan ang mga as to exclusivity, those are the kinds. No? Any questions so far? Naiintindihan nyo. Ayos. No? Okay? As to function, ito, self-explanatory lang po ito. If it is a sales agency, then who gives you the authority? The owner seller, ba? If it is a purchase agency, who gives it? The one who is asking you to find an owner. Who is the buyer? So,